Amen. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord hath made. That the Lord hath made. I will rejoice. I will rejoice and be glad in it. And be glad in all this.
This is the day that the Lord hath made.
As we come tonight with thanksgiving in our hearts, I want to read a word, Psalm 67. God be merciful unto us. Did you hear that? God be what?
Merciful
unto us. And bless us. Anybody need a blessing tonight? Uh-oh, I don't have but two or three people who want me to bless him tonight. Huh? Did not Pastor say last night that we have a God who is faithful and he keeps his
promise?
Now, there's a hang up. There's a hang up. The hang up is this. You have to be connected. And if you are not connected, don't expect him to do something for you. And you are not what? Connected. How many of you connected tonight? The psalmist said, God be merciful unto us and bless us and cause his face to shine upon us. Anybody need the face of the Lord to shine upon you tonight? I tell you the truth. I tell you, this ought to be exciting. This is exciting stuff right here. That thy way may be known upon earth, thy saving health among
all
nations. Anybody need some saving health in here? How many want good health and longevity? Listen to this. Let the people praise thee, O God. Let all the people praise thee. So therefore, we ought to be an instrument of what?
Praise.
We ought to give God continuous what?
Praise.
And it ought not to be somebody have to just keep on asking you to give God what?
Praise.
It ought to be automatic. It ought to be something that just ought to happen because God is good. He's an awesome God. And because of his awesomeness, we ought to continue to give him what?
Praise.
I will bless the Lord at his praises shall come. Be in my. So, look, why do we have to ask for it? Why did you say can't praise it? Huh? Oh, let the nations be glad and sing for joy, for thou shalt judge the people righteously and govern the nations upon earth. Let the people praise thee, O God. Let all the people praise thee. Then shall the earth yield her increase, and God, even our own God, shall bless us. God shall bless us, and all the ends of the earth shall fear him. Anybody want a blessing from the Lord tonight? If you want a blessing from the Lord, he said, everybody, all the people ought to do what? Praise him. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord and bless his holy name. God is good, and his mercy endureth forever. Can you give him a hand clap of praise because of his mercy that endureth forever?
Come on, put your hands together. Come on, Lord. Hallelujah. We bless your name. Come on and give the Lord a hand praise in this place. We come to magnify him. Come on and make some noise for the Lord in this place. Come on and bless him. Come on from the fruit of your lips. Come on and bless him in this place. Stand to your feet and give him praise. Stand to your feet and give him a praise in this place. Is there anybody here that loves him? Is there anybody here that loves him? Come on, come on.
Yeah. to know that there is nobody greater than the God you serve. Come on, can I get a witness that there is nobody greater than the God that we serve? You can search and search and search and search and try to fill a void on the inside of you, but we were created in the image of our Father, and the only one that can create or fill that void that's on the inside of us is the Father. Amen. Amen. You might think it's in a person or someone else, but you can search everywhere, but there's no one like the God that we serve.
A sure shallow burn could find nobody.
on, just lift your hands and begin to lift your voice all over this place. Come on, I know it's a different sound, but come on, just make a familiar sound to him, and that's worship. Come on. May every voice be lifted in this place in worship. Come on, come on, come on. We love you, Lord. We appreciate you. You're King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And we worship you, God. You're worthy of the praise, God. You're worthy of the worship, Lord.
Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God.
You're worthy,
yes, God.
Worthy, worthy.
Yes, God. By your Spirit, God.
Bless the Lord, God.
Yes, God. In the name of Jesus, God.
Of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see. I want to see you. Come on, you know it.
Open the eyes of my heart.
That's right, kid, we're just slowing down. Come on, say, open the eyes of my heart.
Open the eyes of my heart.
Come on, say, I want to see you.
I want to see you.
Every heart in here saying, come on, open up the eyes of my heart. Sing it again.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
Come on, say, I want to see you.
I want to see you.
Come on, say, I want to see you.
I want to see you.
Come on, say again, open the eyes of my heart. And we worship you, Lord.
Holy, holy,
come on, acknowledge the presence of the Lord in this place. I want to see you.
I want to see you.
Come on, once again, sing holy.
on, sing it again. How great.
How great.
This time, sing it like you know he's great. Come on, say how. It's all about you, God. Lord, we're sorry for what we've made of God. It's all about you, Lord. It's all about you, God. Come on, just lift up your sound to him. Give him a personal worship. Come on and give it to him. Tell him who he is. Tell him how much you adore him. Tell him how worthy he is. Tell him how much you love him. Tell him how much you appreciate him. Hallelujah. Service, Lord, we want you to have your way in our lives, God, in our hearts, Lord. God, we love you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord, because God, it could be us, Lord, with no food, God. It could be us, God, with no shelter, Lord. It could be us, Lord. It could have happened to us, God, but you loved us, Lord, and for that, we worship you on today, God. We give you the glory on today, God. We give you the praise on today, Lord. Come on, somebody, some grateful, thankful people in here. Come on and give God a praise in this place. We thank you, God. Come on, if you know it could have been you, come on and give him a praise. If you know it should have been you, come on, give him a praise. Come on, give him a praise, a praise, a praise, a praise.
Thank you. you, Lord. Thank 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 you, Lord. It could have been me, God. It should have been me, God. I got to praise you, God. I got to praise you, God. I got to praise you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Don't watch me praise him. Think about where he brought you from. Think about all he has brought you from. And that's enough to praise him. That's enough for you to tag team praise him with me. The Bible says, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Because if he's been good to you and he's been good to me, we ought to be able to make a noise in this place like never before. You ought to be able to dig down real deep. Lord, have mercy. Yeah. You ought to be able to dig down deep. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Stir up yourself in this place, 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 God. He's creating an atmosphere right now. He's stirring up his anointing in this place right now. He's causing a shifting in this atmosphere right now. And all you got to do is begin to praise him. All you got to do is step in, because he's creating an atmosphere for whatever you need. All you got to do is tap in now, because the water has been stirred. The Spirit is in this place and is in here for you. You just got to praise him. I'm not trying to make you praise him, but you ought to praise him. Yeah, you ought to praise him. You ought not get tired of praising him, because God deserves your praise. He deserves your worship. He deserves you. Open up your mouth right now. You ought to give God more than that. You ought to give God more than that. You ought to go a little harder for God tonight. If you know what he went through to go to one and two generations,
just a little bit, and I know y'all know by now my testimony, but it was in the Polk County Jail in 19, Lord have mercy, 97 when he saved me. On my way to hell, not on my way just to prison, but on my way to hell, he saved me in the county jail. There was not a drummer there was not a keyboard there, and I can't get to the place that I won't praise him unless you hear. So I thank God for the musicians, but we ought to be able to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Yeah. He's trying to push us somewhere. He's trying to push us somewhere. He's trying to push us somewhere. Yes, I thank God for the musician. I thank God for praise and worship. But I can praise him without it. I can sing my own song without it. I don't even know the word, but I can make up a song right now. God, you've just been good to me. God, you've just been faithful to me. It ain't even got to rhyme, but I know when I'm telling God you've been good to me, he loves it. Yeah, I know that song. I want to make you smile, but I want to make God smile right now in the middle of... Yes. Yeah, just tell him yes. Yeah, you ain't got to tell him, stop telling him yes. Just say yes. Yeah, tell your neighbor yes. I praise him. Yes, I worship him. Yes, God. I'm not going to withhold nothing. Yeah. And see, Pam White, I know you understand this language. And what the song means when it says withholding nothing, that means you got to come clean. Yes, that's what it means. And then the song says, Brother Gerard, that I surrender all. Let me help you. Let me just help you what I surrender all means. Usually, when you're locked up, somebody say locked up. And they take you to the county jail. You got to give it up. You got to give it all up. Yeah. Because that what you carry, you can't take in there. And so when they say, I need you to take off your stuff, Lord, have mercy. And see, right now, we can't praise him because we have not surrendered all yet. Father, we thank you right now, God. Father, we thank you for your goodness, your grace, and for your mercy, God. Father, we thank you for your anointing, even our God, yes, God. Yes, Father, I thank you right now, God, for the very hands that's being laid on me, God. In the name of Jesus. Yes, God. Father, be glorified. Pour grace upon my lips, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Help me to speak with clarity and with conviction, God. To speak with power and with authority, God. Father, you told me today, God, even on my way, that you were going to liberate your people, God. Father, I'm reminding you of what you said. God, release a liberating anointing in this place, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Father, cause your face to shine on my countenance. Use me for your glory. And it's in Jesus' mighty name. Let us all say, amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Y'all can take your seats or you can stand. He is amazing. It's about 3 or 4, maybe 5 or 6 people that know he is amazing. He is amazing. He never stops amazing me. I was home today with that little boy. This afternoon with that bottle. And my wife was gone somewhere. And I set my alarm and I said, he need to go to sleep. Because I wanted to go to sleep. This little boy went up to the bookshelf and brought me the books, listen here, that I usually go get to study. Nobody told him. I'm talking about that little 1-year-old baby. And Pastor, I was laying down because I locked him in the den with, because if you leave too many doors in there, he'll come to your house and everybody's house. Amen. But I didn't know what he had in his hands because I heard him say, and he had got the biggest books. He had the concordance, the commentary. And he just made trips and laid them beside me. I said, well, I guess it's not nap time. And Tarvier came and got him after that, and he went on back there in the room. But that was amazing to me. He didn't bring me a toy, but he brought me my weapons. He brought me my weapons. And as I was thinking about that, I began to think about a great interior decorator. All right. Do y'all know any? You know, they have the parade of homes on Hollisworth out in Eagle Brook and Deer Brook, all those places, Christina. And I know they have some show homes for people to see, all decorated by
great interior decorators. And I began to think about the best interior decorator that there ever was and that there ever is or ever will be. And I began to think about how he painted the sky and threw clouds out there. And I say, he's so awesome, pale white, because there's nobody that got a brush to reach up there where he paints at. And then I began to think about all the chandeliers that people put in their house. They go look for them, what man has. And I thought about the sun that never needs a new bulb. Lord have mercy. I say, he's awesome. I say, he's awesome. I say, and it has an automatic system. It's not up under the solar system. I say, but the sun knows what time to calm down. Because who put it in place? And so I just gave a lot of thought on how he threw the stars out there and the planets out there, and can't nobody copy his work. He is amazing to me. And I said that to say this. Once you have looked at the handiwork of God and experienced God, it is hard to be impressed. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You know, I watch all kind of cars, all kinds, from a dollar to $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 cars. And their problem with me and Brother Era is we don't do flips. They bring brand new cars to us for us to wash. And all they have to do is say, I want you to see my car. They want to impress us, but now I got to charge you for showing it to me. Yeah. This car ain't dirty, but you told me you want me to wash it. You really don't want me to wash it. You want me to see it. And now you like it. I said, it's good. He said, would you get? No. It's nice, but it's not impressive. Yeah, y'all didn't hear me. Yeah. And see, sometimes people begin to look at you strange when they see that you're not easily impressed. Lord help us. Yeah. And then we were, got a phone call, and I know this is good and free. We were talking about football, and he kept on talking, and I shared something with him, he shared something back with me. And after I responded, he said, man, are you impressed with anything? I said, well, do you know who saved me? I said, for me to be impressed, you got to tell me something better than what he's done. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. If you have your Bible, I want you to turn to the Gospel of St. Mark. Amen. Amen. We got a bad Savior. Listen while you turn to Mark. Reggie, he said, in a little huddle, he said, I'm finna die, but I'll get back up in 3 days. And got up with no therapy. You know, usually when somebody go in a coma, they need help. But he got up saying, I got all power in my hand. I'm just talking about my Savior. Maybe you're not happy, but that's what's impressive. For him to allow them to kill him because they didn't have power to kill him. Good night. Mark chapter 5, verse 25. And I know we have heard this preached a whole lot of times. Amen. A whole lot of times. How many times? I don't even know where I'm at right now. I'm halfway high. See, Pastor, a lot of us ain't never been high. or don't want to tell it up in here. And I would bother my friend Eric. He would come in, give me the definition of happy. We ain't gonna bother him tonight. But when you high, you flow, then you owe something. Amen. You basically not even in your environment. You don't really understand. And Brother Greg sound like you know. But Mark chapter 5, verse 25, reads like this. It says, and a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years and had suffered many things of many physicians and had spent all that she had and was nothing bettered, but rather grew worse when she had heard, somebody say heard, of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. Pastor, when I was back there, I was circling the word touch and I was writing the word connect, and I heard you out here talking about the word connect, and I knew it was time for me to get up because God was confirming right then. Verse 28 says, for she said, somebody say she said, if I may touch, if I may connect, but his clothes, I might be whole. I might, if it's the Lord's will, I shall be whole. And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that virtue had gone out of him, turned him about in the press and said, who touched my clothes? And his disciples said unto him, thou seest the multitude thronging thee, and sayest thou, who touched me? And he looked round about to see her that had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what was done in her, came and fell down before him and told him all the truth. And he said unto her, daughter, thy faith hath made thee whole. I'm going to read this for you just in case you can see this. In verse 28, she said, I shall be whole. Yeah. In verse 34, her faith done made her whole. She said it out of her mouth, and it came to pass. She spoke it, and it happened. She had power in her mouth. And if I could use for a title, Induced by Faith. Induced by Faith. Webster's tells us that the word induced means to succeed in persuading or influencing. The word persuade means to call someone to do something or to call someone to believe something. And when God gave me this title, today wasn't a day that I thought that I needed Google to talk to me about inducing. Amen. And so I waited for Sylvia to get home because I said, if anybody know anything about pregnancy, with all these children we have, my wife ought to be able to tell me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's why when you walked in the door, I said, Sylvia, what does it mean to be induced with labor? Somebody say labor. This is how God began to show me this. They won't induce, Pastor, nobody with labor that don't have nothing in them. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And there's a few reasons that they will induce labor. Mm-hmm. One of them is when the person, the woman, is having complications with the pregnancy. Mm-hmm. Another one is when there's a risk of waiting on labor. When the risks are high. Another reason is when the person that is carrying the promise, somebody say promise. Yeah. Has passed their due date 2 to 3 weeks. Lord have mercy. They should have already experienced their promise. But because they have not experienced their promise, the doctor will release medication into them to force their labor. Lord have mercy. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And the way they do that is they usually get an IV and cause it, Lord have mercy, to run through their system and give them a jump start. Yeah, 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 yeah. And then their body begins to speed up. Somebody say, speed up. Yeah, yeah, yeah. This thing that this woman had for a while, listen, for 12 years, she suffered of many things. Yeah. One of those things was, Pastor, she was suffering with disappointment. Lord, have mercy. Mm-hmm. If you deal with anything for 12 years and you spend your money going to people that you think ought to be able, Lord have mercy, to help you, and you leave there and not get nothing. Look, let me help you go see your doctor. If I go to a doctor, make an appointment, Lord have mercy, at a revival, yeah, 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 yeah. If I make an appointment to come to a revival, knowing that I need to be revived, and I go to a revival for 12 years and don't get better, I'm going to get very disappointed. Lord have mercy, because these doctors are in place and they ought to have something to help me. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, yeah, they've been getting my money for 12 years and my condition have not changed, Lord have mercy. And so now I'm getting disappointed with the doctors. Yeah, yeah, yeah. The Hebrews, yeah, yeah, called her condition because women, it's usual, say usual, for a woman to have a period, yes. It's usual for the woman to bleed, yes, yes, yes. But the Hebrews called her situation a zog, Z-O-G. That's a chronic discharge. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Lord have mercy. That's a chronic discharge because it has lasted for a long period of time. Lord have mercy. We talk about chronic problems now. And this woman had this chronic discharge for 12 years. And instead of her getting better, she was getting worse. Mm-hmm. But something happened. Somebody say something happened. Here she is, isolated. Somebody say isolated. Not only she's isolated, she's labeled. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And everybody know her problem because she's been bleeding for a long time. Yeah. The law says that everybody got to get away. I'm just paraphrasing. It's over in Leviticus. That means that if she come in this church back then and sat on any pew in here, we got to get it up out of here or call it unclean. If she came and hugged you, you're unclean. Now you got to walk around and say, I'm unclean until you get right. So now, because in 2014, because we don't do it in 2015, nice nasty. Ain't no nice nasty people in the church. You know what that is, Sister Annette? You looking at me like you don't know what that means. A nice nasty person is one of those customers that we not in church, just out there with me and Aaron work. They want to shake our hand or they want to hug us in the morning, not when we get dirty. Because they got on nice clothes. That's nice nasty. Y'all really with me? Nice nasty is a person
that, yeah, I'm not going to tell you which one of my children, but I had one that would play sports all day on a Friday night. Come home, want to drink out of your juice first. Let me have some. But I got to have some first. But then won't bathe his rotten butt to Sunday. Nice, nasty. I got some funny, funny ways. Ain't nobody here like that now. And I had some very, very nice, nasty ways because I drank all day. Was never thrilled about that weed. But if you rob or put it in your nose, we can't really get too close. But I'm sinning too. Nice, nasty. Yeah, yeah. What I'm doing, Minister Hayes, is okay. But what you're doing is different. Nice, nasty. Filthy minded. Y'all got it? So we can hurry and get to the table. You ever, not in here, you ever seen anybody go get dressed and spray on cologne or perfume without bathing? That's nice, nasty. Just so y'all understand, them bird baths. Lord have mercy. Yeah, nice, nasty. So, they had a mindset that we don't want to get close to you. And see, sometimes in the body of Christ, people don't want to come around because they sense that spirit that you don't want to be around me because you know what I've been through. It's okay. Let me tell you something. And we finna go home after I tell you about this in a few minutes extra. Deacon Anthony, I shared pastor with them at Sanctuary Praise. I told them, don't tell me what nobody did before they got here. I said, your preacher is an ex-con. I said, don't come here telling me. I said, I'm an ex a whole lot. We got to invite the exes in. Do you understand what I'm saying? Why would they come to church if they didn't need no help? Why would a doctor send his patients away? And see, our problem is we think people got to come to church looking like us. The devil is a liar. There's going to be some people that have babies, not one baby out of wedlock, but 2, 3, 4, and 5. And that don't mean that they send no words to us. Lord have mercy. That there's somebody else. Because you may not have a baby don't mean you ain't getting in no bed. There was another song back in the club, they said, now everybody get on jump. You know what that mean? If you understand, that means jump to it. Yeah. Just cause you ain't never been to prison don't mean you ain't never done a crime. Am I right about it? I'm not legalizing it to break laws, but I have a problem with my foot on the gas. I've never been up 10 doing 70. I drive fast. I drive, like they say, with the flow of the traffic. That's wrong, just as wrong as somebody driving with suspended license. He know he ought not to be driving a suspended license. And Terry the preacher know that he ought not be riding 80 on cruise. Y'all, I promise y'all still about to pray for this a little while. I'm telling you the truth. Lord have mercy. But here this woman, she's not getting better. But she gets worse, and she's disappointed now. And it says when she heard of Jesus, it said that she heard something. Mm-hmm. And what she heard made a difference. All right. What you're hearing make a difference in your life. Listen, when somebody begins to speak up under the anointing and begin to speak with unction, what you hear ought to push a difference in you. There's nobody, no woman that ever had a baby that the doctors put that stuff in and it didn't make a difference in them. So once you are induced with faith, something ought to happen in you that shows up on the outside. The Lord said the doctors induce a medicine. That book you have with 66, all of that is medication. There's all kind of prescriptions in there. It's prescriptions for the crazy people. It's for prescriptions for the addicted people. It's just prescriptions for the people that need peace of mind. I'm talking about whatever it is, he has already prescribed. We got to go to the doctor. I promise you we need to go to the doctor. And the thing is, at the doctor's office, there's not too many people that ask others what you in here for. Because both of us need something. Lord, I understand. And it ain't your business what I'm going to see it for. Lord have mercy. So she hears that Jesus is coming. And because she hears that Jesus is coming, she does something that changes her life by her using what she hears and what's in her, and she pushes it out her mouth. The word is nigh thee, the word of faith which we preach, even in thy mouth. If you're not using your mouth, you're not walking in faith. Lord have mercy. Our God is a speaking God. Our God is a talking God. He said, let there be light. He didn't just think about it. He said, let there be light. He began to speak things into existence. And if you want something to come to pass in your life, you got to open up your mouth and start saying something. You got to say what the word says. And she said, somebody say, she said. That word there in the Greek means Lego. Yeah, y'all know them Lego building blocks. I started to bring them, and the baby did play with the Lego. I guess I missed that one in the spirit. He was playing with the Lego, but the Lego blocks over there in Winter Haven, which used to be Cypress Gardens, right? Amen. The most boring theme park in the world, so I pray that nobody here work for that place. But Cypress Gardens, I'm not talking about Legoland. But at Legoland, this is why they got Legos. Pastor, a little kid will get Legos, one box, got 150 people. No, we got 66 tonight. 66, Genesis to Revelation. Got 66. And a child named Terriss would go in here and he locked up in prison, right? And he'll get in his mind as he look at the pieces. And he'll begin to build with these blocks and put them together until he put together deliverance. Lord, listen. It says she Lego. And so what you do is you get something in your mind. And then once you get it in your mind, you take the word of God and you begin to speak it. And the same blocks that'll build your deliverance will build your peace. And see, if a child is trying to build a car, and he gets his car, now he don't need the car no more. He wants the upside. So he takes that alone. He don't go buy a new box of Lego blocks, but he begins to build bigger with the same blocks. And then if he want to get a house, he gets those same blocks and build his house. Lego, you got to put it together with words. You got to design what you want to come to pass with words. This table, it wasn't just put together by a wood man. Somebody said, I want it to be this length. I want it to be this height. I want this kind of wood. I want this kind of glaze or tarnish on it. Somebody had to speak that. So if they would have just went out there to the men out there working in the shop and said, listen, in the spirit, listen to this supernatural discernment we want God to have. They came out the office and just looking at the workers. And the workers looking at them crazy because they ain't saying nothing. And see, God only responds to faith-filled words. When you speak words of faith, that's when blocks begin to get together. God wants us to open up our mouth and begin to speak our deliverance. This woman said, I shall be whole. And she didn't just sit in the house and begin to talk about it. She began to bust loose. And see what the Lord said, when he induces us to labor, the first thing happens to a woman, she might as well get in position in her mind. Lord, talk to us. When God drops something in your spirit and you know that you're carrying something, and it takes a woman to carry a baby. Lord, talk to us. And God told me to make sure I tell everybody here tonight that the body of Christ is female. Yes, yes, yes. So everybody in the body of Christ ought to be carrying something. God should have already, no, not should have, God had already impregnated you, but the problem is you don't want to push. The complications you're having, good God, is telling me that you are pregnant. The trouble that you are experiencing is telling you that you are pregnant. Let me tell you how a baby, you know how we say the baby kicking feeling? Let me tell you what that is. That is when the baby is being shifted by waves down into the delivery canal. Lord, good God. So that pain that you're feeling, all that is God shifting your promise in the right place. Stop whining and start saying, promise, come on out. You ought to stand up and say, my promise is coming on out. Yeah, yeah, you could be in the room all by yourself. I know I may look crazy, but this baby got to come out. I've been waiting on this baby to come out. And none of y'all ain't gonna stop this baby from coming out because I've carried it way too long. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I've carried this thing and it's time, good God, to push it out. Yeah, yeah. Tell your neighbor, baby, push. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Tell him, baby, push. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. You can holler all you want, but baby, push. Good God. God, push them, God. God, I pray that you induce them with more labor because we need to push. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And let me tell you this last thing about this pushing. There was a little game that we used to play down in the circle. Y'all ever had any hood games? Let me tell you, Pastor. I'm 44 now. Yeah. 44. That's a blessing. I'm in my right mind. I ain't locked up. 44. That's a blessing. For me, yeah. But Pastor, in the neighborhood I go to, even at home, let me tell you what I did. I told him, Sandy, take me to the flip lady house. There's some stuff that you're gonna always remember. They say, I see you wanna flip. I say, flip, scraper, frozen cup, whatever works. I spoke it out my mouth and I followed them to the flip lady house. I went in expectation, anticipation, to go get me a flip. The flip lady went home, but now I know where the flip lady is at. Do you understand what I'm saying? But there was a game we used to play down there, that was just something. There was a game, everybody on your feet. Yeah. There was a game we played down there. And Pastor, somebody always was in charge. And sometimes, Lord, the person that's in charge cheats. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Because he's the leader now. Sometimes, once people get positions, they begin to play with the rules. God talk to us. And so here, I got a buddy. We down in the circle down there by the cesspool. Down there, right down the road. And I'm gonna use Deacon Anthony tonight. And I need Aaron too. I need y'all to go to the door. Please. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes, God. I know the game. I understand this game is called red light, green light. 1, 2, 3, stop. Y'all know the game? I'm gonna say red light, green light. And so when I say green light, y'all need to make y'all way because of what y'all hear. Red light, green light. Y'all trying to beat each other. Red light, green light, 1, 2, 3, stop. Red light, green light, 1, 2, stop. Red light, green light, 1, 2, 3, stop. I'm cheating for it. Red light. Now I should have sucked him back, but that's my buddy. Red light, green light, 1, 2, 3, stop. And this is what the Lord showed me with this. We got to get to the point that when somebody else misusing rules, I gotta make it up in my mind. This is what this woman did. They're misusing them rules to hinder me from getting to Jesus. And you got to get to the point that ain't nobody standing up and stopping me tonight. And that's what the Lord said tonight, that I've induced you with labor. And you got to get to the point that I'm not going to let nobody stop me. I've been disappointed for 12 years. But I'm going to decree and declare that this baby got to come out of me. And God is telling me not to speak to twins in your womb. And it may be somebody that may be carrying twins in the natural. But this is what he's saying in the spirit realm right now. He said, the reason you have had complications so long is because you're carrying something that nobody else ever carried. The lady said, why am I thus? And God said, it's because there's two nations in you. You're talking to people that have carried one baby. But God said, because I want to give birth to my people tonight. God is saying this is for everybody in here. Good God. God said, because I want to give birth to you tonight, I want you to do double in the kingdom. Oh, God. Yeah, God said, I know what you've been through. Yeah. I know all the disappointments that you've had. I know how you've been isolated, how you've been labeled. But God said, even with the blood dripping, you made up in your mind that this time I'm not going to let nobody stop me. I'm not going to let nobody tell me. We ain't praying for people that got a lot of babies. We ain't praying for nobody that smoked crack. But tonight I made up my mind that I got to get to Jesus. I might not use malice tonight. I might not say excuse me right. But I come to get in the press tonight. I come to make my way all the way to Jesus. Yes, Lord, I got to get to Jesus tonight. I got to get to Jesus tonight. They're not going to shut the altar down tonight because I got to get to Jesus because I have been induced with labor. Yeah. I have carried, Lord have mercy, this thing too long. And if you feel like you've carried it too long, God is going to make a deposit in you right where you're at. It's going to take faith to receive this. It's going to take faith. Yeah. I feel something in the spirit right now. Yes. Let me tell you what's happening. God says in the book of Amos, he said, I will do nothing in this earth realm without revealing it first to my servant, the prophet. And so when God speaks something to a prophet, there's always going to be somebody around, oh Lord have mercy, a spirit that don't want to hear it. Let me give you a little bit of proof. God said through Elijah, he said, by this time tomorrow, there's going to be a blessing. And there was a man that said it's not going to happen. And the prophet said, you're going to see it, but you're not going to experience it because of what you said out of your mouth. And I say this right now to you, in reverence and respect of God. Hear the prophetic anointing right now. Yes. Yes, Father, I pray right now for mercy, God. For those the enemy is trying to bother to not believe what's about to be said. Father, you said, God, that you wouldn't allow no words to hit the ground, God. And God, when you were saying that, all you were saying is, my word will come to pass. I speak now into every womb in this place in the name of Jesus that what God has put in you, Yes, in the name of Jesus. That God will induce labor in you in the name of Jesus. That promise that you thought something was wrong, God say, that was me giving you waves of my glory to let you know I'm still kicking. Yes, the trouble that you're experiencing, the pain that you're experiencing, God say, that's me. That's me. Let me tell you, when you're toting a promise or carrying a promise, you're carrying God, because God is his word. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, I speak into their belly right now in the name of Jesus. Release the medicine of your anointing, God. Induce labor, God, in the name of Jesus. Induce miracles. Release the spirit of faith, God, in the name of Jesus. God, cause them to begin to take an action because something is in them. Call them to begin to scream because their promise is telling them, I got to get up out of here. Your promise is growing inside of you, God is telling me right now. Your promise is growing inside of you. Your promise is maturing inside of you right now. Yes. Your promise, your promise, your promise. In the name of Jesus, God. Jesus. Your promise is greatness, I hear, God. In the name of Jesus. Your promise is to prosper and to be in good health, even as your soul prospers. Your promise is to do exploits. Your promise is coming to pass. I come against discouragement and defeat and disappointment right now in the name of Jesus. Change disappointment to an appointment with destiny, God. And Father, I pray that you release a grace on their lips, God. As they begin to speak faith-filled words, that they can see your promises coming to pass. Father, cause their water to break tonight. And God is saying, some of you already know your water has been broken by the tears that you're shedding. The pain that you're going through right now, God said, those tears is letting you know that your water has broken. In the name of Jesus, you're pregnant. You're pregnant. You got to know he's in you. You got to know that your promise is in you, because you have been induced by the word of God. You have been influenced by the word of God. And God is trying to persuade you right now that that what I put in you has nothing but life in it. There's nothing dead in you. Listen to God. Your dreams are not dead. Pastor God just told me to tell you that your dream is not dead. Your dream is not dead. I hear God, Pastor. He said your dream is not dead. It has, Lord. It has too much life. He said these words that we speak, they are spirit and life. In the name of Jesus, Father, I thank you, God. Father, I thank you for every healthy pregnancy, spiritual and natural. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you right now, God. Father, we thank you for changing our season by the words you allowed us to speak out of our mouth. God is releasing season-changing words tonight. You can change your season with your lips.
Father, quicken us by your Spirit. Father, we thank you, God. Father, we give you praise, honor, and glory. It is in Jesus' mighty name, let us all say, amen.
While you're still standing on your feet, how many of you are pregnant with a promise? Come on, don't play. How many of you really pregnant with a promise? How many have been waiting on the promise as the ministers come? As the ministers come. You're pregnant with the promise. You've been waiting for the promise. Remember, there was an issue. She heard. She spoke. And then she touched. If you're here tonight, and you're pregnant with the promise, and you're waiting on that promise, come touch and agree with someone that you be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding. That you be steadfast. That you're not going to abort the baby, but you're going to allow the baby to be born, come forth. If you're here tonight and you're pregnant with the promise, you've been waiting on it. Remember, there was an issue. She heard. She spoke. And then she touched. You're pregnant with a promise. You've been waiting. Remember, she had an issue. She heard. She said. And she touched. So why don't you come? Let someone pray with you. See you. even if you have considered aborting the baby, aborting the promise, because of the time that it has taken and it still has not come forth, hold on to the promise. Until full term. So we'll let someone pray with you. Sing with me. Why don't you get in the receiving position?
My heart. Trustees, if you're here. Please do not forget Jerusalem. We have baptism tomorrow at 6 o'clock. 6 p.m. We will have baptism here. At 6. Our Father and our God, we thank you for this opportunity to celebrate through our giving. Teach us how to give. not grudgingly, but cheerfully, not sparingly, but bountifully. Thank you for the resources that you have provided for yourself. You gave it to us that we may give it back to you. We say thank you for this privilege. Thank you for this opportunity. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Exalted. We thank you for the precious promises that you have given to us. We live and we are going to abide in faith. We will be bound by faith. And we thank you, God, as we have faith, that we will add to our faith virtue.